I'm a makeup artist and these are the products that I actually use on my clients. My name is Megan. I'm part of the social and content team here at Adore Beauty and I've also been a makeup artist for over 7 years. So that is a lot of faces, a lot of glams and a lot of products that I have tried out. These are products that I have found just work universally on so many different skin types, skin tones, and I really just can't do a glam without them. Okay, let's first start with some primers. The first one I have raved about for so many years and I'm pretty sure I've mentioned it on this channel about 500 times, but it's the Napoleon Purtis Autopilot Skin Primer. It's great for all skin types, especially good for those with normal to dry skin, and it just leaves the skin feeling super hydrated without that greasy, oily finish. Honestly, this is the genuine one from my kit, so it's almost run out. It smells really comforting. It blends in so seamlessly, and as you can see, it just leaves a really, really hydrated feeling on the skin. It's also got vitamin E in there to help soothe. Next up, this is a bargain product, but I honestly have been loving it. This is the e.l.f. Matte Putty Primer. Now, I love applying this to clients that have a bit more of an oily T-zone or even cheek area. Even though it is designed to mattify, it doesn't leave your skin feeling dried out, and it also ensures that it doesn't leave a weird film on the skin that other mattifying primers can sometimes do. A little bit goes such a long way, but it just goes on, mattifies the skin, still hydrates it a little bit so that you're not feeling cracked or dry. It's already instantly mattified what was once a very, very glowy back of the hand. Now onto foundation. I could not pick one, it was way too hard. And to be honest, I always cocktail my foundations together to ensure that I'm getting the right shade, the right coverage, and the right finish for each individual client. I have about 8 different types of foundations from different brands in my kit, but there are 3 that I just cannot go without. So the first foundation that I mix into pretty much everyone's foundation cocktail, as I like to call them, is the MAC Studio Radiance Face and Body Foundation. This is a super light to medium coverage foundation. It does leave a glowy radiant finish. So as you can see, it blends out really, really seamlessly and is almost undetectable on the skin. Now, because a lot of my clients are after long wear makeup, like bridal makeup, special event makeup, I would rarely go in with this on its own, but I will always mix this in with a few other foundations. Next up, I don't think anyone will be surprised with this. It is the Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk Foundation. This is a makeup artist favorite foundation pretty much all over the world and for good reason. It just has a beautiful satin finish. Really does set in place once you've buffed it into the skin, and it's really, really good for long wear. And of course, it wouldn't be a fully stocked makeup kit without Estee Lauder Double Wear. This I always pull out for anyone that has an oilier or combo skin type that wants their makeup to go the absolute distance. Next on to one of my all-time favorite setting powders. This is the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish Powder. These have been popular for years and years and years and years. They can be used as a setting powder, as a bronzer, as a finishing powder. They are just the ultimate all-rounder. Now, this formula is quite cool. It's baked and it actually has pearlized pigments in there that gives your skin a little bit of a satin natural finish. One of my favorite things about this powder is that even people with super dry skin that are petrified of powder still like this once it's applied on the skin, and is great at setting even those with the most oily of skin. So it really is just an absolute all-rounder. I had to, of course, choose an eyeshadow palette, which was so hard to narrow it down to one. Don't mind the state of it. This is my true palette from my kit, but this is the Soft Glam palette from Anastasia Beverly Hills. So my personal favorite shades are Burnt Orange, Orange Soda, Sienna, Rustic, and Cypress Umber. This is really just the perfect combination of shimmer shades and matte shades, and you also get warm and cool tones. This is one that is applied to pretty much all of my clients, regardless of what type of look they're wanting. I can always find a shade in here that I need for the look. Whilst we're on the topic of eyes, I have to talk about these Napoleon Purtis Luxe Eye Sticks. Now, I have these 4 shades in my kit, but there are way more online that you can shop from. They are super velvety and they go on so seamlessly. As you can see, they're super pigmented and they buff out like a dream. This is the shade Cheeky Chestnut. These are super long wearing, so for anyone that finds that they get really, really oily lids, this is a great option to try. The next product is probably an unsung hero, but I genuinely cannot glam without this. It is the Makeup Forever Aqua Seal. Now, this is a liquid sealant that goes in and can transform almost any medium into a smudge-proof, water-resistant formula. You can use this on gel eyeliners, you can use this with loose shadow pots, and it basically just takes whatever formula it's applied to and makes it smudge proof and transfer proof. Now, I'm sure that we have all been at the stage where you've had a gel eyeliner that has pretty much dried out, and now you don't really know what to do with it because when it applies, it's chalky and it kind of gets stuck along your eye. So I'll give a little example of what this liner looks like before I have applied the AquaSeal. It's pretty dried out. It's not very pigmented. So I'm just going to add 1 to 2 drops of AquaSeal into this dried out eyeliner. And then I'm going to dip my brush in and let's see how the liner has been transformed. So it literally makes it brand new again. One of my favorite things about this little concoction as well is that it can really, really make the liner a lot more malleable and easy to draw onto the eye, which means that you can get a way more precise eyeliner. Of course, I have to speak to these gel liner pots from Napoleon Purtis. This one is in the shade Frappe. This has been so, so popular in my glams lately because everyone is wanting that beautiful soft glam. Well, everyone that comes to me anyway. And a brown liner is the perfect way to do that. It's still rich enough to give your eye that beautiful dimension. However, it's soft enough to make you look really, really natural. I of course had to throw in a brow product. This is the Benefit 24-Hour Brow Setter. I use this in my own makeup as well as on my clients. I absolutely love the fine tooth bristles that come on the brush, but also I just love the formula. It goes into the brows, it doesn't leave a white residue, it's not very sticky, and they set in place super quickly. So they are of course my top picks from my kit that I cannot glam without, but keep in mind that I did not even bring in any lips or cheek products. So if you do want to know about those, maybe we can do a part 2. Let us know in the comments. If you want to see more videos like this, just click over here. Otherwise, we'll see you next time. Bye.